In lesson 2.3, you do a demonstration in which you take two cups of ice water, one you leave exposed to the air, and the other you place in a zip-closing plastic bag and seal it tightly, trying to get as much air out as you can. And eventually, students will see that the one left exposed to the air has moisture on the outside, and the one in the bag does not. And the question is why? What happened? So it's the start of a conversation about condensation. And the question is, what happens when water vapor condenses? Like, why did this occur on the molecular level? And the big ideas that you try to get to in the lesson are that condensation occurs when the molecules of a gas, in this case water vapor, move slowly enough that they attract each other and are able to come together and change from a gas to a liquid. And another aspect is that cooling increases the rate of condensation, and kids will actually help you design an investigation to see if that's true. And that's a big part of this activity, is that students help in the design of the investigation. So let's take a look. The first thing that you do is you take about a half a cup of hot water, and students place another cup on top upside down and just wait for maybe 30 seconds, and you see that the top cup gets kind of cloudy. And the question is, what is that? If kids look at it closely, they can tell they're tiny droplets of water on the inside. And if they take the cup off and feel inside with their finger, they can tell that it's wet. So why did that happen? We show a molecular model animation to help kids understand what happened. There's the cup of hot water is on the bottom, and another cup is placed on top. And here, the water vapor molecules are on the inside of the top cup. But eventually, over time, they cool somewhat because the top cup is relatively cooler than the bottom. And when they cool, they attach to each other, and that's condensation. The question for students is, could we come up with a test to see if cooling the water vapor even further increases the amount of condensation? Well, the idea is to take two cups instead of one. So these are two cups of hot water with a larger cup upside down on each one. So they're exactly the same, except one of them is cooled with an ice cube on top. So kids get to understand variables and how to control them. And there's only one thing different about these two samples, and that is that one is cooled with the ice cube. And then after a couple of minutes, they can remove the ice cube, use a paper towel to get the excess water off the top, and see that on the inside, the cup that had the ice has larger drops of water than the cup without ice. So on the inside, there's more water vapor turned into liquid water when it was cooled with the ice than the one that wasn't. So in the student activity sheet, you know, aside from explaining what they did in the activity, we have them try to apply these ideas to the water cycle. This idea that evaporation and condensation together make the water cycle happen. Also, there's a molecular animation that shows a sample of water, but it's water that's inside a container. And we go up to the surface, you can see that there some water molecules are evaporating, they're leaving the liquid and becoming a gas, but some are condensing, they're leaving the gas and becoming part of the liquid. And the idea is that if a container is closed and kept at the same temperature, eventually it'll come to an equilibrium where the same amount of water evaporates as condenses. In fact, we have a teacher background piece about that. If you go to this link right here, there's a discussion about this dynamic equilibrium between evaporation and condensation. If you're in an NGSS state, the performance expectation, MSPS 1.4, says develop a model that predicts and describes changes in particle motion, temperature, and state of a pure substance when thermal energy is added or removed. Well, this lesson 2.3 works pretty well with this performance expectation in that kids are looking at particle motion and temperature, and the idea is that if you cool the water vapor, it'll change state from a gas to a liquid. Also, if you look closely at the foundation boxes, science and engineering practices, kids are developing a model to predict and describe a phenomena, in this case, condensation. They're planning and carrying out an investigation. For disciplinary core ideas, they're looking at heat transfer. In this case, heat is moving from the particles of the gas and they're being cooled on the side of the cup, and they're changing from a gas to a liquid. And for cause and effect, if the effect is an increased rate of condensation, the cause is the extra cooling of the water molecules, the slowing down of the molecules, allowing them to condense and change from a gas to a liquid. So good luck with the lesson, and thanks for watching.